Hello everyone, I, Jhalak Red, from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication, welcomes you to the session of Electromagnetic Theory. Today, we are going to discuss about Unit 3, that is time-varying field and Maxwell's equation. So, let's start the session. First of all, as we discussed in Unit number 2 about the overview of electrostatic and magnetic field, in that chapter, we have discussed some Maxwell's equation. In this chapter, we have to revise that topics like divergence theorem's equation, that is delta D equal to OV, then multiplication E dot dl equal to 0, etc. Okay, so first let's start with the Maxwell's equation for static field. Here, this Maxwell's equation, we divide it into two parts, that is for static field and the other one is for the time varying field. So let's see the Maxwell's equation first for the static field. So for the static field, first equation is Faraday's law. So statement of Faraday's law is EMF induced in a loop is when magnetic field is changing in the vicinity of it. Means if the magnetic field is changing, then EMF is introduced in that particular circuit. So basically, electromotive force is given by integration of E dot dl, where E is electric field intensity, and at a complete closed path we have to integrate it. So this integration is line integration. We already have seen this equation in unit number 2, that in a closed path when we have done the integration, then because of that closed path has the same initial limit and final limit, so the integration of E dot dl will become 0. So here also if you see this, then EMF induced in E dot dl is 0. So we can say that integration over closed path for E dot dl becomes 0. So this is the integral form of Maxwell's equation for static field. Now, according to Stokes' theorem, we know that whenever we need to convert or we need to make a relationship between the volume integration and surface integration, we need to follow the Stokes theorem. When we need to give a relationship between the surface and volume, then we have to follow the divergence theorem, and when we want to make a relation between the line integration and surface integration, at that time we have to make Stokes theorem. So here the line integration equation is this. So we have to make the relation between the line and surface. So we have to follow which theorem? Obviously Stokes theorem. So for Stokes theorem, we can say that the integration of E dot dl is equal to the del cross E ds over surface integration, like this. Okay. So now if you see this equation, that integration E dot dl is 0, and according to this equation, integration of E dot dl is equal to surface integration of del cross E ds. So if you compare this equation and this equation, then you can say that del cross E ds over surface will become 0. So obviously full point form the right hand side is 0, so we can compare del cross E equal to 0 at that time. So the final equation is in the point form of Maxwell's equation, that is del cross E equal to 0. So these two equations are for the steady field and it is called as Faraday's law. Okay. Now the second law, that is Ampere circuital law, we have already discussed about the point form of Ampere circuital law as well as the Ampere circuital law, that whenever we want to follow the line integration of magnetic field intensity over a closed loop, means whenever we want to make the closed path integration of magnetic field intensity, then it gives us the total current. Means we can say that integration of H dot dl equal to I. Okay. So this is the mathematical expression of Ampere's law. So the statement is, again, the line integral of H around a closed path is equal to the current enclosed by that path, means integration H dot dl equal to I, and I can make a relationship with J. J is nothing but the current density, so we can say that J is equal to I upon A. So I is equal to surface integration J dl, because it will be equal to the current density into area. Okay, so this is called the integral form of Maxwell's equation. Now, if you want to make a surface integration, then we have to make the relationship between line and surface. So, whenever we need to find the relationship between line integration and surface integration, we want to follow, we have to follow the Stokes theorem. So, according to Stokes theorem, line integration of HDL is equal to surface integration of del cross HDS. Here, this term del cross H is called curl of vector H, means curl of magnetic field intensity. Now again we have to compare these two equations, this equation and this one. Okay, so if you compare this both equation, so you get del cross H equal to J, because according to this one, equation number 1 and equation number 2, HDL is equal to I and is equal to surface integration of JDS, and according to equation number 2, HDL is equal to del cross HDS. Now if you see this equation number 2 and equation number 1, so both has the surface integration term. So this surface integration term can be compared and it will be equal to del cross H equal to J. So this is point form of Maxwell's equation. So we can say that for the third one, Gauss law for the magnetic field, we have already discussed this about in unit number 2, that the total magnetic flux crossing the surface is equal to 0. Okay, so now whenever the total magnetic flux crossing the surface equal to 0, means here if you see, it will create loop. Okay, so the loop will be created, means incoming flux is equal to the outgoing flux. Whatever the flux coming inside, it is equal to the outgoing flux. So total will be 0. Okay, means here if you see this cube, then incoming flux is equal to the outgoing flux and surface integration of D dot D is equal to 0. This is the mathematical form of Gauss law. Now if you want to compare the surface with the volume integral, then you have to follow the divergence theorem. Whenever you want to make this relationship between the surface integration and volume integration, so here one equation is in form of surface. Now if you want to make a relationship between surface and volume, then what you have to do, you have to use the divergence theorem. Okay, so according to divergence theorem, surface integration of dds is equal to the volume integration of del dot dd, means you can compare surface with volume. Okay, so according to that you can use this equation. So as I said, del cross surface integration BDS equal to volume integration del dot BDV. Okay, so again on the left hand side, if you see, surface integration BDS is there, so you can compare both the terms. So if you compare that, you can easily make a relationship like del dot D equal to 0. So this del dot D equal to 0 is called as the point form of Gauss law for magnetic field. Okay, now let's move towards the next law, that is Gauss law for electric field. So for Gauss law for electric field, again we have discussed about it in unit 2 in detail. So this is one type of revision of unit 2 for the Gauss law for electric field. So according to this statement, the total electric flux crossing the surface is equal to the total charge enclosed by that surface. Now total electric flux is denoted by psi, and it is equal to the total charge. Total charge is Q. So electric flux is equal to total charge, means psi is equal to Q. But here if we want to make the another equation for the flux, then according to the flux density, we can say that flux density is given by D, and it is equal to flux per area. So D is equal to psi upon A, and that psi upon A, in which psi is our electric flux, A is our area. So psi is equal to surface integration dds, means dds equal to Q. Okay, same way we can also write dds equal to psi, because psi and Q is same. So here again we can make this equation like according to the standard charge configuration, charge can be written in form of line and in form of surface as well as in form of volume. So if we want to make the relationship for volume integration, then obviously Q is equal to volume integration rho v dv. Why in this equation? Because here in this equation, this rho v is our volume charge density, dv is volume integration, and q is total charge. Volume density, volume charge density means coulomb per meter cube, and volume is into meter cube, so coulomb per meter cube into meter cube, so it becomes the total charge q. Okay. So now, if you want to compare these two equations, you can easily compare because psi and q is same according to Gauss law. So if we compare this equation number 1 with equation number 2, then surface integration dds is equal to the volume integration rho v dv. Okay, this equation. Now again, if you see this equation, here surface and volume relationship is there. So whenever you want to follow the surface and volume relationship, you have to use the divergence theorem. Okay. So according to divergence theorem, surface integration dds is equal to volume integration del dot ddv. So this del dot ddv on the right hand side, again we can compare this del dot ddv with our volume integration rho v dv also. So this equation comes, dds is equal to rho v dv. Okay, again if you compare this 3 and 4, third one and fourth one equation, then we can say that del dot d equal to rho v. This del dot d equal to rho v, this equation is called as the point form of Gauss law for electric field. So this is our fourth equation for Maxwell's equation. First equation is our Faraday's law. Second equation is Ampere's circuital law. Third equation is Gauss law for magnetic field. And fourth one is Gauss law for electric field. Okay. Now the fifth one, continuity equation of current. Here, according to the statement of continuity equation, the total current crossing the closed surface is equal to zero. Total current crossing the closed surface is equal to zero means whatever current coming inside will be equal to the outgoing current. Similar to KCL, Kirchhoff current law, that incoming current is equal to the outgoing current. So now if incoming current is equal to the outgoing current, then we can say that the algebraic sum will be equal to zero. So here, incoming current equal to outgoing current, and here total current. Now again we can make the relationship of current with the current density. So current density is given by J, and current density is basically the current upon area. So current is equal to the surface integration JdS. Okay. So this JdS, total current is zero, is equal to the surface integration JdS. So we can compare surface integration JdS equal to zero. This is the integral form of continuity equation of current. Now if you want to make the relationship between the surface as well as the volume, then which equation you can use? Obviously for surface and volume means divergence theorem. So this right hand side term, surface integration J dot ds, can be written as volume integration del dot JdV. Okay. So surface integration JdS equal to volume integration del dot JdV. But according to the continuity equation of current, total current is zero. So this surface integration J dot ds is also zero. So this equation can be written like this, means del dot JdV over volume integration becomes zero. So if this term is zero, then we can easily say that del dot J is also zero. So this is about the continuity equation of. So now this is about the steady field. In the next session, we will discuss about the various time varying field. The same Maxwell's equation we have to follow for this time varying field. So we will see about this in the. So this is all about the steady field Maxwell's equation. Now in the next session, we will discuss about the time-varying field Maxwell's equation, in which we have to make some modification in our continuity equation of current as well as the displacement current. And for the two laws are same, whether it is a time-varying field or steady field, that is Gauss law for electric and Gauss law for magnetic. So these two laws are same for time-varying field as well. So, in the next session, we will discuss basically about the Faraday's law for the time-varying field, continuity equations modification, and displacement current. Okay. So, if you have any doubt or query regarding the steady field Maxwell's equation, you can ask me on my email ID. Thank you for watching.